Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. We're just going to do a really quick, about a 10-minute scope, and just show some of the work we're doing with this dog right here. This dog right here, Junior, he's from New York. He came to us getting into dog fights, highly leash reactive, huge resource garner. Obviously, you know, didn't know his obedience commands at all. Was obviously never able to do this, you know, whatsoever. This is John. He is my head trainer.
Hey guys.
And if you're brand new to us, solidcaninetraining.com, solidcaninetraining.com. Check us out. We always do 2 to 3 training videos a day. So the main key is this dog right here. So I'll talk a little bit. All John's gonna do is probably just, we're gonna break these guys, meaning we're gonna release them. They're gonna all run around. John's gonna probably most likely just call Junior over to him, sit him, down him, place him, throw the ball. This dog was never able to do stuff like this without getting into a fight. So the power of rehab and training. We remote collar train every dog. If you're not familiar with remote collars, there's no shocking or zapping on the dogs at all. We do all low level stuff. The higher the distractions are, which this will be a very high distraction, obviously you might have to increase the levels for the dog to listen, because the dog is also not paying attention to John as much. All right, so if you're brand new to who I am and what I do, go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com. You can also click on the little character in the corner, share this on Facebook. You can also share this on Twitter, and then share this on your Periscope. Which dog is the problem? Well, all dogs have problems, even my own. This is John's dog right here, Buddha. This is one of my dogs, Girl. This is Jackie, my dog, and this is Uma. But this dog right here, Junior, is the client's dog. So he came to us, to our boarding train facility a few weeks ago, getting into dog fights, not knowing any obedience, not listening at all, off-leash recall didn't exist, resource guarding over balls. And you're gonna see, so right now he's in place, he's nice and calm. What kind of dog, this is John's dog right here. He's got a reddish dog, a reddish brown dog. That's it. All right, that's it, that's his dog right there. All right, so I'm just gonna let John do his thing. Uma, 9, plots. Good. So I'm just gonna let, what breed, it's a cane, I don't know what breed it is. It's a mixed problem. Most of these, you know, it's a mutt. It's a mutt. It's a mutt. All right, so we have to make this short. John's got a client coming in, so I'm just gonna let, no, we don't teach dogs how to crawl. We don't teach dogs how to crawl here. That's more of like a trick, we don't do that. This is duration work, but we're also waiting to start. So I'm just gonna let John do his thing, and I'll answer questions as we go.
Break, good job.
So now is a good time for Junior to misbehave, because when all dogs are in high drive, a lot of dogs do that. So that this interaction good. That you see him doing, this inner right here.
Good job.
So just the fact that this dog is walking around like this.
Girl, okay. Here.
And we're gonna let the dogs bark a little bit.
Good job.
We're gonna let the dogs be in high drive a little bit, because we wanna see what this dog does. All these other dogs are naked except for the client dog, meaning none of these dogs have collars on except for the client dog. John could give a verbal or a remote collar stim to correct. So what we're going to do is we're going to throw it. John's probably going to throw the ball around. And right there is prime fighting energy, right there.
Good.
So we do this on purpose. We want to see what Junior does. All right. So from high drive to a...
Right.
We don't use vibration at all. We use stim. So John might use stim or he might use continuous depending on what he's asking the dog to do.
Good, sit. Good. Good. Girl.
So all these other dogs are running around.
Girl.
And the dog that John is working with, which is our client dog. So we're letting mouth one another. All depends on what their intention is.
No, Junior, sit.
Will they all go back to place if you tell them to? Depends. I mean, it all depends. I mean, the only one we're really worried about right now is Junior.
Good job.
So, the only one we're worried about is Junior right now.
Good job. Good.
Continuous and stim. Well, you can actually do a continuous stim. There's something called momentary, which is a split second, and there's something called continuous, which is up to 10
Here.
Seconds.
Good job. Out. Nine. Good.
Okay, so we John did out. So here's another great time for a dog to do nonsense.
Great.
So that's a good time for a dog to misbehave.
Good.
So the power of training is right here.
Sit.
If the dog is listening in a high distraction area.
No, Junior.
So he said no, he's bringing him back. No, we never use vibration mode. So vibration mode, I'm not against it. Is mouthing at the neck between dogs ever okay? Yes, it is. I allow my personal dogs to do that all the time. Good, that was beautiful for Junior not to move right there. So vibration, people use vibration for a couple of different reasons, but if you're using it because you think it's gentler than stim, then we don't, because it actually freaks a lot of dogs out. You also can't go up and down on this on the vibration. Is the camera sideways?
Out.
Yes, my camera is landscaped. So what I would do is I would make sure that you've got the latest update. The latest update of Periscope. If you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. Solid Canine Training. And you can go to our website to see it. If the dogs start playing mouthing, depends which dogs.
Nine. Girl. Good. Junior, break.
Yes, you always want to know the dog. Yeah. You always want to know the dog. The stim is from you. Junior is, how old's Junior, John? Do you know?
I want to say four. He's not a puppy.
He's about 4 years old. Do we increase the pressure? At this point, no, the dog would just get a higher level stim. There's a lot of different ways that you can use the remote.
Girl,
a lot of different ways you can use the remote.
Good job. Girl,
out. All depends on what it is.
Girl,
so we're going to allow some growling because we want to see what the dog does. This is more of just a showcase one. How did John get into dog training? Have you ever had a dog that became more aggressive during your cattle training? No.
Down.
No. The dog's
Junior.
Already aggressive.
Junior. Good boy. Sit. Down. Good.
Good. How did John get into dog training? I hired John 7 years ago to move rocks.
Good.
He moved pea stone in my play yard 7 years ago, and now he's my head trainer, and he
Junior.
Runs my training center.
Good boy, buddy.
He does all of the training programs Down. Here. He trains. He's in charge of training all the dogs, and he's got two assistants.
Good job.
That was beautiful right there. Right there, all that. Look at that. That was beautiful. Yep.
Good.
Yep. There we go. Beautiful. So Junior and one of my dogs both went for the ball. No growling, no fighting from Junior. So Junior's doing great. Junior's doing fantastic. We just want to showcase the power of training.
Good.
Not necessarily the work we're doing, but yes, we're part of the work we're doing. But remember, this is a dog that couldn't do this, 4 weeks ago. 4 weeks ago. It's a great job, but trust me, John, we try to get bit by every day. So we work with some really, really hard dogs here. We specialize in behavior
good
modification.
Job.
Yeah, do a Skype, fill out a form.
Good job.
Fill out a training contract.
Good boy.
So feel free to share this. There's a little character in your bottom corner. Hit that. Share it with your Periscope followers. Share it with your Twitter and your Facebook fans. Also, give everybody lots of hearts.
Good job.
So this
Junior,
is great for all my dogs.
Good boy.
Don't call. If you want to do a Skype, do not call. Fill out a training contract on the website. Because all they're going to do is tell you to fill out a training contract on the website. So we want you to fill out a training contract on the website. You'll do that. Yes, will they get? Yes, they will. We do a lot of training with the owner. This dog is on a e-collar technology 300. E-collar technology. Now, training goes to the owners as well. There's just handing the dog off to the owners won't work. This is Jackie. This is Junior. This is Girl. This is Uma. Yeah, great progress. I mean, this is great. This is great stuff. And this is Luna. I saw John saying down to the client dog. With, I don't know. I didn't see that. I mean, there's a lot of high drive right now. You know? And also, remember, guys, dogs aren't perfect. Dogs are not perfect. So keep that in mind. We're not making robots here. We're not making robots. These are not competition obedience dogs. These are all family dogs. So, yeah, sometimes dogs blow off commands. Sometimes we miss it. What we're trying to do is just showcase the work we're doing. That's all. Oh, for some reason we just went out of focus. There we go.
Yeah.
So he's putting him on a small place, which is really hard to do. So for this dog to listen to John with all these dogs running around, it's very, very challenging for the dog. Oh, I get it, Gigi. My dogs are German. They speak German. That's why we do German to my dogs. Because we don't want my dogs to listen. But if they did listen, so say John told Junior to down, and one of my dogs down, it's no big deal.
Good boy, Junior. Good job.
Junior.
So.
No. Place.
Great.
Good. Down.
Good.
Girl, here, place, nine, girl, place,
Platz. Jackie, Platz, Uma, Platz.
What a doubt, no.
Jackie, nine.
Down.
What does the resource guards, we don't do, for tricks, there's no tricks. So for duration work, it's the level of correction you give the dog. Once the dog knows it, you've got to have a level of correction that you give the dog, or else the dog won't hold the command. That's the magic to duration work. That's the magic to duration work. So again, this is John, he's my head trainer. And we're with Solid Canine Training. We're right here in Providence, Rhode Island right now. And we're just showing some progress we did with the dog. He resources guard balls. So balls was his big thing. But dogs resource guard can resource guard anything. He was also not able to be around other dogs.
Here.
Oh, good boy.
Down.
Good job.
Nice. Good job. So lots of hearts for John. Lots of hearts for these dogs that are working hard. Remember, all dogs... For any tips, place means go to a mat. So place is like right there. So that's place. That's place. This is place. This is place. Technically, this is place. All right? So these all these dogs are in down, except for girl. Yeah, for we don't do tricks. We don't do tricks. The Platz is down in German. Place is place. We just say place. But we don't do tricks, but we encourage people to absolutely train your dog as much as you can with different things. Yep. So obviously this dog has dramatically changed the way it looks at life. Just by its energy. Good work, John.
Good
stuff. So John's gonna break them and watch what happens. Ready?
Break.
Good boy.
High drive.
Good job.
And no fight.
Good.
Yes.
Good job. Good job, man.
So when I leave for my RV trip on Sunday, Uma's going with me, and these two dogs will be with me in the RV. Jackie stays here. He stays here and he'll be working.
Good boy.
Good. And Buddha stays here too. Buddha's John's personal dog. He takes him home every day. And this is Junior. Is break optional? You should have some release command. You should have some release command. Break just says, you know, now you're done with like what you're doing and you can either, you know, just wander around or move to the next task. Anything else you want to show?
That's it.
Yeah, it's fine. If it's fine if you did hand commands, just switch to verbal. It's no big deal. It's no big deal. When's the dog going home? Probably next week.
Sunday.
Well, Sunday. This Sunday? Dog's going home on Sunday. Girl here. Girl here. Good girl. Climb. All right, good job, good, all right. So I'll let them growl just to see what this other dog will do. All right.
Good job.
Yep, all this equipment is just handmade. Just go on to, this is handmade, Home Depot. This is handmade, Home Depot supplies. Just go to get a book on agility equipment from, it's wooden, yep. Just do agility equipment book on Amazon. This is all handmade. Now we don't do agility, we just use agility equipment. So, you know, I love showcasing the dogs here, the work we do. I also love showcasing my awesome staff. It's important that people realize that I'm just a big mouth of the company. I just make a lot of videos and I travel the world doing seminars. But the real work with my company is with my awesome staff. So John's my head trainer. So I think it's really, really important that people understand the work we do and how hard my staff works. So we just got in 3 aggressive dogs this week. So, which means like one dog is still muzzled. He hasn't been taken off muzzle yet. He's been here for 48 hours. And 48 or 24, John. When did that dog come in? 2 days ago?
Tuesday.
Yeah, Tuesday the dog came in. So still muzzled up. Will you meet John at T3? Yep, John's here.
Good boy.
Yep, John's here. Yep. He's here. He doesn't participate in it, but he's here. Yep. Yep, someone's got to be the big mouth. So most better off than me. Good. Good. So that's it. That's the story today. This is Junior. No, we don't do that. The only thing we do that is, dogs don't push the little mower. We just do that for distraction work. So, fun, confident stuff. So here's a great example of confidence building. So, yeah. So this is great. This is great stuff. All this is like just pretty much not fighting and listening.
Being a dog.
John hasn't been on the button, I don't think, for a while. What's your working level, John?
6.
John's working level is 6 right now. No, you're not allowed to say you missed Tokyo. So, Nikki, no, you're not allowed to say that. So get those thoughts out of your head. Those are naughty thoughts. Give your husband a hug.
Yeah.
Clients here?
Yeah.
All right. So we got a client here we got to work with. I'm madly in love with you. Do you drop on other trainer periscopes? I don't know what that means. Yoda, what does that mean? Watch all my videos. You can fully train your dog by watching my videos. Just remember that. Fully train my dog. Hold on, let me put these dogs away. Hold on. Here, Uma, let's go. Here. Whoa. Dog just jumped the fence. No, Junior. Hold on. Do you know that dog climbs fences?
Yeah,
he just climbed a fence. Yeah. Here, guys. Come here, come on, kennel. Who am I missing? Jackie here? Good. This is Ronan. Come on, guys. Nope. Girl, Uma, Checky, good. This is where my dogs hang out. And there's some kennels there for them. So when they're not working, that's my dogs. All right, so that was it. That's the story I got for you right now. And any quick questions about what you just saw? Not questions about your dogs? Yeah, he jumped the, we call that the airlock system. He jumped that. So we can fix that. We would just give him a high stim on the remote. So any questions about what you just saw? Oh yeah, a lot of dogs jump fences. What dog growled? A couple of my dogs were probably growling during play, and we let that happen because it was a different kind of growl. It was not a growl. I want to see what Junior does when he hears growling. That's the number one priority. I want to see if that would trigger him. But a lot of that stuff is play. So when my dogs are playing, I allow them to growl. I allow them to growl. I allow them to tug toys with each other. So if one of them grabs a toy, the other one can grab the toy, and I let them do that. Nope, John is John right now. How often do you use the collar now? Probably just for correction. Probably just for correction. But keep in mind, guys, keep in mind, the collar does not do the training. So keep that in mind. You can put a collar on a dog, push buttons, the dog will not listen to you at all. So it's so important that people understand that that remote collars, anything, training is why the dog's doing what it's doing. So that's all due to training. So yes, we use remote collars because we like to be able to give dogs information up close or far away off leash. But it's so important that the people that are not familiar with the collars fully understand that the collar doesn't train the dog. Training trains the dog. So you've got to understand markers, timing, drive. You've got to understand all that. You also have to understand how dogs learn, the learning process. You've got to understand how to be proactive to your dog, how to use an aversion, how to properly use punishment, how to motivate the dog for yes, how to motivate the dog for no. So, and I say that, number one, because I know a lot of people are confused about the collars. Also, I don't want people going out just to get a collar and think they can push buttons and their dog will listen. The dog absolutely will not listen. It won't. So I don't speak Japanese. Put a collar up to me. I don't care. I notice Max is getting better. Oh, yeah. I've got 25,000 posts on my Facebook page. Solid Canine Training. Just look me up. Solid Canine Training. I've got a YouTube channel with 1,000 videos. So Max, there's no Max here. So there's a Mac back at my house. He's another German Shepherd. So I'm not quite sure which dog you're talking about. All right. So little character in the corner, hit the character, share me on Periscope, share me on Facebook, share me on Twitter, follow me, and then also turn on your alerts. Yeah, I've got tons of social media. You can fully train your dog to off-leash capacity. With my videos. If you really need help, this is not a help video right now at all. This was just showcasing some work we do. Yeah, dogs get better the more you train them. The more you work with them, they get better. It's training, right? So it's training. It's training. It's all training. Age of the dog, probably between 3 and 4. Age of me, I'll be 50 in 2 months. Age of the other dogs, Uma is 12, Jackie is 7, Girl is 3, Buddha, I don't know. And then this is, Lauren's dog's outside. This is Lauren.
Are you looking at me?
No, but the camera is. This is Lauren, she's my personal assistant. All right. So yeah, dogs, I'm not sure, Gigi, maybe I missed your question. But yeah, dogs get better the more you work them. Oh, good. Good, yeah. So the more you work, you want to do active. Do my dogs ever fight? No, they don't. This weekend, we did have a skirmish, our first one in a long time, between Jackie and Mac back at my house, which was stopped immediately, but this is a training center we've got. It's a 17,000 square foot training center. It's about a mile from my home. There's a lot of different rooms here. We've got a lot of different rooms, a lot of different training areas. Right now I'm sitting on a couch, which is sort of like, I really don't have an office. So I just pretty much run my business from a laptop. So I've got 10 dogs. Two of my dogs got into a skirmish this weekend. Yep, watch the replay. So the older they get, but just keep in mind, you can have a 6-month-old fully off-leash trained dog. So it's just pretty much it works on how much time and consistency you do. So if you're working on your training all the time, absolutely your dog is going to get better, you know, as it gets older. But what I want people to do is not wait. Like, some things I just don't want to wait for a long time to be trained, you know. So some things it doesn't take years, but it's consistency, right? Just like work, just like anything you do, like a job or a sport or a hobby or a skill you're trying to do. Like if you want to do video editing, the more videos you edit, the better you become. So that's what's really important. But absolutely. So the more you work with your dog, the better it gets. Yep, every day. But it's easy to work with your dogs every day on training because you just incorporate it into your life. So, you know, right now there's no dog next to me, but if I brought a dog out, I would put it in this bed. That would be place. So, Gigi, I do a steady schedule of training, but don't beat yourself up over if you missed it. Do you know what I mean? It's like, don't be like, oh my gosh, I missed my 4-to-5 training. Just you can incorporate it into something else. So don't beat yourself up. Oh, that's awesome, Chef. Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, Sierra did great in Ottawa. And I just announced 2 Australian seminars. Yeah, Gigi, don't beat yourself up. Don't feel guilty. Don't let people shame you. Don't do any of that stuff. Just like you do what you... Gigi, do the best you can. Do a periscope. The 2 Chihuahuas don't do much of anything. They're Linda's dogs. So I never worked with them ever. I've never worked with those dogs before. There's some videos of them swimming. There's videos of them on the treadmill. But they pretty just hang out. They pretty much hang out and chill and go on the treadmill and go outside. And they run around. They run around a yard. When the pool was open, they swam. If you've got a high-energy dog while at work for 12 hours, you know I'm really transparent. I would look into a doggy daycare or a dog walker. I would really reconsider that decision and that option. The bottom line is, you've got to work. You've got to work. Do I mind that they're not trained? Not at all. That's Linda's decision. And it's not like they're barking all the time or and destroying things. they're pretty easygoing dogs. Yeah, 12 hours is pushing it. But high energy, That's a long time. I would look into an option. Do Linda's dogs work for their food? No, they don't. Remember, Linda's dogs are Linda's dogs. That's her gig. Knock it off. That's her gig. All right. Don't forget this Sunday, we leave for our RV trip, 18,000 miles. Oh, cool. Good for you. That's awesome. That's great. Great for getting into training. Great for getting into training. Yes, they interact with my dogs. Yep. Yep, they interact with my dogs. What's up, Spence? Hold on. Let's keep this dog out. This is Sonny.
Nice.
And this is Spencer. He's one of my other trainers.
Hi, guys. Good.
Sonny, down. Good. See that? Look how good of a job that Lauren did with her dog. Seriously. How old is Sonny?
Year and a half.
Sonny's a year and a half, and he's a Chihuahua German Shepherd mix. And he loves walks on the beach, and he's madly in love with Lauren, and Lauren brings him to work every day, and he does, it's good because he spends a lot of time, not a lot of time, he splits his time between his kennel, but outside socializing, so he actually helps other dogs do better that are here. So there's a lot of photos of him, like him and Zoe, which is that a pit bull, that silver pit bull, they seem to be best friends. Actually, what kind of, on a serious note, what kind of dog is this? Do you know?
We did one of those DNA tests.
Yes, which is a scam.
Yeah, so
you threw your money away, yes?
Shush. Take away the grain of salt. He's a husky mix with terrier
stuff. So I think he's more of an Australian mix.
That's what people say, yeah. But
so,
look at him.
Yeah, he's a good dog. And he wants to so badly leave place and run over to mama.
You can't see his face from here.
Yeah, I see. I can tell by the side, yeah. Yeah, that was a joke. He's not a Chihuahua German Shepherd. That was a joke.
Maybe.
You want to give him kisses? Spaghetti Dragon, best way to get your face bit off. Don't be doing that. Maybe not with this dog, but how do you socialize? We socialize outside in our socialization yard. I'll do one. I'll do a Periscope on socialization. Maybe I'll do that tomorrow. All right, but I've got tons of videos. Tons of videos. He focuses on Lauren. That's because Lauren has got a hot dog in her mouth right now.
I'm a veggie.
He focuses on Lauren because Lauren's done an awesome job.
No, he just wants to be released.
Yeah. He's waiting for the release command because he wants to go and snuggle with Lauren. Well, who wouldn't be? I mean, look at Lauren. I want to snuggle with her. I said that off the clock, by the way, Lauren. So... faces are overrated. Stop bursting my happy bubble. Sorry, Spaghetti Dragon. I want to keep you. I want to keep you from not getting bit. I want to keep you from not getting bit. That's all. That's all. Great dog. He doesn't bark. He's safe. He gets along with the other dogs. He's good for socializing. He enjoys his walks. So all the staff can bring their dogs here to work. They all can bring their dogs here to work. So, it's nice. It's nice. So, and officially, all my staff, all my full-time staff has disability insurance on me. And actually, I met with my financial guy again today. And e-collar trained? Yep, he's e-collar trained. But he's naked now. Sonny's mostly naked. He's mostly naked. Yep, he's Lauren's dog. Yep, Lauren's dog. So we talked to we're setting up not a 401k, what is it? An IRA? Simple IRA. Yeah, simple. We're setting up a simple IRA for the staff. So all the staff is going to have a simple IRA. Do I need an ER doctor on staff? This week we might. We got a couple of really aggressive dogs in. We got a couple of really aggressive dogs. So we might need one. We'll let you know. I'm on my Periscope, yeah.
What ER?
What ER? Where do you live? Do you work at Miriam Hospital? I don't know. Medical? You're an ER nurse? You're in Texas? Periscope? We Periscope everything. We did a Periscope yesterday with an aggressive dog. Yesterday, we did a Periscope. We make videos and photos and Periscope everything. So, all right, that's it. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. What folks can do is click the little character on the corner. And you can share me on Periscope, Facebook, and Twitter. Do we offer medical to your employees? Yes, full-time employees. You make delicious cupcakes? I don't know if that'll get you in the door. I don't know if it'll, what do you want? You want cupcakes, Lauren?
Cupcakes?
Yeah, someone's trying to bribe us with cupcakes.
What do they want in return?
I don't know. What would cupcakes get them?
Ice cream.
So what would ice cream? Someone brought an
ice cream. Next year, I'll take off my birthday again.
Wait, what would an ice cream cake get somebody?
Time with Sunny.
Cheesecake?
No.
Ice cream cake.
Ice cream cake.
So if Lauren, if you get Lauren an ice cream cake, you can snuggle with Sunny.
Is that good enough?
I don't know. I haven't heard back.
That's all I got.
That's all she's got. That's all she's got. And she's not, and Lauren's not single. Everybody wants to know. Lauren's not single. Thank you, Yoda. Oh, we have an ER doctor. I'll take cheesecake. I'll take pumpkin cheesecake this week. And we have an ER doctor that can make an ice cream cake.
Wow.
Wow.
ER doctor and ER nurse?
Yeah. Huh. The nurses work harder.
When I worked in the ER, the nurses worked real hard.
That's Lauren's words. The nurses work harder. That's Lauren's words. So if anybody took offense to that. The doc can suture bites. Yeah, I suture my own bites. I got a lot of them. If anybody has any stitch kits, suture kits, they want to send them to me, I'll take them. I'll take some. I can use some suture kits here. I'll take some of those. Antibiotics. If anybody has any antibiotics, I'll take those. That's a joke. That I don't want people doing. Now I'm asking for prescription drugs on Periscope. That's a joke. That was a total joke. I absolutely am not. All right. That's it. I might be on the air one more time this week, tonight. We'll see. We'll see. Maybe I can see if I can get Linda and the kids. Maybe we'll do some Angela. Maybe we'll do an Angela Periscope. You can watch Angela play with his cars and his trucks. Who knows, man? People love everything on Periscope. They love everything on Periscope. A thread and a needle, I got that already. I got that already. All right. I'll see everybody later. Take care. Madly in love with you guys. Thank you for allowing me to teach.